weight loss drugs are forcing companies like Walmart to rethink grocery sales, and it's having an unusual impact on its users, sparking a debate about its use as a fertility drug. Women who have struggled to get pregnant and now take GLP-1 drugs like Ozempic are getting pregnant, and doctors are now looking into whether it can fight one of the leading causes of infertility in women. Bloomberg's Madison Muller reported on this. She joins me now. It is the number one read story on the Bloomberg terminal. People are wondering why Ozempic babies are now a thing.
Yeah, it's so interesting because I was talking to an obesity doctor here in New York like 4 or 5 months ago just about what he was seeing with patients, and he brought up the fact that several of his patients were surprisingly getting pregnant, and these were women who had long struggled with infertility, had kind of just given up on the idea of having a baby, and then found themselves pregnant, surprisingly. And like, kind of tucked that into my back pocket at the time, and over the last few months have just heard that more and more, and it's taken off on social media. There's like Facebook groups with, you know, 500 plus members that are called like, I got pregnant on Ozempic. And it's really interesting, and doctors are prescribing it more now, not necessarily as a fertility treatment, but to help women who have struggled with infertility, because weight loss is known to help with some of that, and it might be treating some of the underlying causes of infertility, so it's just really interesting.
I think a key statement you made is might be. Mm-hmm. In your story, one of the shocking pieces in it is the idea that they're moving forward without the data.
Yeah.
Why are doctors comfortable doing that, prescribing this without really knowing?
Right, no, and that is a big question, and doctors are kind of split. There are some that are like, these drugs have been around for 20 years in diabetes. We have some data, at least, in diabetes, and we feel comfortable enough extrapolating that data and prescribing them to women, obviously, before they get pregnant. No one is saying that women who are actually pregnant should be taking these drugs, but there are other doctors who are like, there's such a history of safety issues with some other drugs in pregnancy, and this is something that should be vigorously studied, and we need to do that right now. But it's been hard to, well, one, the supply shortages are so bad, so it's been hard for researchers to actually get these studies off the ground because they can't get the drugs themselves for their studies.
So how is this changing the narrative around Ozempic and how it's used generally?
Yeah, I mean, it kind of adds to the many possible uses that Ozempic could have. There are so many other disease areas. We've talked about some of them. I mean, from heart disease to kidney disease, like, the potential for these drugs, I think, only keeps growing. But as this excitement grows, we also need to remember that it needs to be followed with studies and with safety reviews that need to happen in tandem or before they can be prescribed this widely. And so it kind of adds another question mark and like intrigue to this Ozempic story.
Safety, I think, is mm-hmm. one big question mark. Is there any concern among doctors who see this being used, or even patients?
Yeah, I mean, there are some concerns because in the drugs really haven't been tested widely in women who are trying to get pregnant, but they've been looked at in animal studies. And in those animal studies, there were some concerns, like that some of the animals, their offspring had birth defects and there was more, you know, issues with miscarriage and things like that. So again, the companies are setting up these registries to track women who have gotten pregnant while on the drugs, and that's something like the FDA is working with them on. And so hopefully we'll get more data soon, but right now it really is a question mark.